I'm Jill Pruetz. I'm a professor of anthropology in the Department of World Languages and Cultures at Iowa State University. And we just published what was the first account of lethal aggression within a chimpanzee group in West Africa. And this is what we're looking at back here. What I was able to film regarding this finding was reactions by the group members to the adult male that was killed, one of the former alphas in the group. And so while we didn't see the killing itself, it occurred at night, we could hear it from our camp. We were able to record several hours of data on how they treated this male's body, and also I took some footage of the behaviors themselves. So what we see oftentimes in the clips is really investigating the body. They will go up and sniff the body, especially they'll kind of move it. What you can see though is that they're very fearful. And so if you see a lot of screaming and bare teeth, that sort of thing, that's fear in the chimps. So even though he's dead and he's been dead for several hours at this time, they're still quite afraid of the body. And at one point, actually, in the morning, they became really frightened for some reason. One chimp was moving his body around and they started alarm calling back at him. And then they started attacking the body again. So that was something that we filmed. And then also there are other cases where you don't have that much excitement, but females are investigating the body once the males have kind of moved out of the way. And then we did film a few cases of cannibalism, so where individuals were actually taking small pieces of flesh off of the body and eating them. And then after some time, something happened to scare one of the males, and then everyone came running back, and I didn't expect that. And I guess what was even more unexpected was the, I would even say, brutality with which they treated the body. So that was really shocking. It was very hard to watch. You know, we knew that male, even though he had been out of the group for 5 years, which in itself was a big part of our paper, because that's something you don't often see with chimpanzees. But it was really difficult to watch these chimps that we follow every day basically mutilate the body in some cases. And so it was really interesting. And also just to try to understand their understanding of what death is, and they were very afraid of him, and they never got over that fear as long as we were there, so 3 hours. And even the next day when they went back to look for him, we had buried him after they left, they were still quite fearful, and so very on edge and nervous. And you can see that even if you're not an expert as far as chimp behavior goes, you can see that there's excitement and fear and that sort of thing in these chimps. We think that as far as this male goes, he was only one of four alphas we've ever known, and he was the first alpha, so we don't know as much about his, you might call it his dominant style, as with the later alphas. But he was, qualitatively, he was probably more aggressive, and I think he did instill a lot of fear in the other individuals. And when he tried to come back in the group, which happened soon before he was killed, he was really trying to come back in as a high-ranking male. So I think that didn't sit well, especially with the young males that had just matured. So we had a lot of males in the group, 12 at the time, and 5 of those were young males. So I think that they were really strongly against his behavior, his coming back into the group as a high-ranking male, which you don't normally see with alphas. But like I said, I was really struck by how fearful they were of him, and I don't think it was just of a body, but this was a really fearful reaction. So I think in part that stems from how this alpha male, you know, reigned during his time as leader of the group.